Hello, it's Julien from Saveurs Kitchen again. Today we're gonna do a Black Forest and... What's that? Oh, pardon, sorry. Black Forest, I was saying. And so we're gonna start to do a chocolate Genoise. It's a chocolate sponge. Genoise is, you know, very French, bloody French. And also a dark chocolate mousse, layered with a vanilla mousse and with some fresh raspberry, some griotine poached in kirsch alcohol. And that's gonna be the Black Forest. Let's do it. Right, so we're gonna start to do the chocolate Genoise. So I'm gonna need 5 eggs. Crack it into a bowl. For this, it will be nice to have, you see, a mixer. It will be much easier. So we crack all the eggs with no shells. In there, we're having 125 grams of caster sugar. And need a whisk. Mix it through. Okay. And then this gonna go on a bain-marie to heat up the sugar. And like that, the sugar is gonna melt into the eggs. And usually it's about 60 degrees. We have to stop and start to whip it. So let it melt. It's a bain-marie, you can leave it and do something else now. So when that's gonna be whipped, we're gonna have to put some flour, cocoa powder and corn flour. Flour here we've got 75 grams. Corn flour, 25 grams, and 12 grams of cocoa powder. Good quality if you can. So we need to sieve it into a parchment. Sorry. It's very easy. We sieve it. That's done. Okay. Let's have a check on our eggs. It's not ready yet. Don't make it too much boil, otherwise it's gonna make a scrambled egg. Just gentle heat, let's check, it's still quite cold. So now I think it's ready. You put your finger, shake it, and it's warm. And there's no more pieces of sugar. So that's fine, it's ready to whip it. So let's be lazy a bit. I'm gonna use the kitchen aid. Very lazy. Let's make ready the ring. There you go. Well, you can use any cake mold, any tins. It does the job, it's just to cook it. Huh? See, start to go. Okay, so now it's well whipped. You can see the print of the whisk into your mix. Let's check if it's ready. Yeah, when it does a ribbon and it stays on top, that means ready. Don't bang it too much because all the hair you did incorporate into it by whisking it, if you bang it, it's gonna go down and it will be not as light as it should be. So we're gonna pour this one, the sieve flour, cocoa powder, corn flour, with the maize, very gentle. Very delicate. You got to keep the lightness as much as you can. So this is a chocolate one, but you could do a plain one with some zest to make it a bit citrusy. Nearly done. Et voilà. That's done. Pour into your mold. There we go. Bang it in your oven, 160 degrees. I will just have to wait. So we will always have to check it when it's gonna cook. It depends. There is no time to cook it. So it's just by pressing the top. And if the top stay in, when you press it down, if your print stay in, it's not cooked. If your print goes up again, last minute is cooked, so you have to take it out. We'll see. So now we are gonna make the dark chocolate mousse. Okay, so we need, it's just for fun, some whipping cream. Yeah. Double cream is too heavy, whipping cream is much lighter. For mousses, it's much better. So here we need 1 liter of whipping cream. Two whipped. Okay, we got 1 liter. Let's be lazy again. Let's use the rubber, the kitchen aid. Have to start it slowly, otherwise it's gonna go everywhere. Okay, for the time being, we need a syrup to make a sabayon. So we're gonna have the whipped cream whipped, then we're gonna have a sabayon, put it together, and the melted chocolate. It's the best chocolate mousse. Okay, so we've got 1 liter whipping cream, 600 of the best quality dark chocolate. We're gonna need for the sabayon 8 yolks and 1 egg. And for the syrup for the sabayon, we need, if I remember, 300 caster sugar. Yeah, and 120 water. And this, we cook it up to 100 10 degrees. Okay, so we're gonna crack our eggs to make it for when while we are waiting our sugar bury up to 110 degrees. We're gonna crack our eggs and we're gonna melt our chocolate in a microwave or bain-marie, is up to you. Just to be careful, in the microwave is burning quite quickly, the chocolate. So here we've got I need another pot. There you go. 8 yolks, right? You can keep the egg white for something else, but I got plenty, so I don't keep it. It's always a bit difficult to separate egg white and yolks. If you want, you can, to make it easy, you can shake the eggs first. You see, if you shake it, it's gonna separate much easier. Look, that's it done. Oh, I forgot to shake it, that one. Shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it. Hop. And one whole egg. Okay, whipping cream nearly done. That's enough. Don't whip it too high. Right. In a clean bowl. And we're gonna use the same bowl to whip our sabayon. Don't need to wash, don't need to clean it. If it's well scraped, it's fine. Whipping cream in the fridge. Okay. Yolks, eggs into this bowl. We're gonna wait our sugar, which is ready in a minute, 110 degrees. So we put it in. Ready. There we go. So we're gonna let it whip now. Until it's cold and until it's whipped and light. Let's check the chocolate. Far from being melted. A bit more. Okay, let's see if it's cooked. I'm not sure, huh? You press it down. Oh, no, 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 it's very fluffy. Not at all. A little bit longer. Okay, that's ready. Look, it's cold at the bottom. It went cold, it's whipped. That's great. Love this sabayon. This on a poached pears on a plate, or a gratin dish, poached pears, sabayon lava with a bit of Port William alcohol, put on top and under the grill. Beautiful desserts. Okay, So we've got our whipping cream, sabayon gosin, there you go, and the chocolate melted, not too cold and not too hot, the right middle, maybe your blood temperature, that would be good. And then when you mix it through like that, you bring more lightness. If your chocolate will be too cold, it's gonna set straight away into your cream, because the cream is very cold. So that's why you need warm chocolate. And then you mix it through like that. From the middle to the top. Like that. Done. That's fine. Okay. So we got the dark chocolate mousse, the genoise. Let's check the genoise. A bit longer. Yeah, a bit longer. Okay. So now we need. Usually, Black Forest is made fresh for the customers, for a restaurant, so, or for the family. So the people is gonna make it with a dark chocolate mousse, layered with a chantilly, whipped chantilly. But because I want to freeze it, so I'm gonna make a vanilla mousse, and it intense the flavor of your Black Forest because you got a vanilla flavor as well. So a vanilla mousse, and let's do it now. Okay, so now we're gonna make the vanilla mousse. All right, so for the vanilla mousse, we need some crème pâtissière. The crème pâtissière, you can catch the recipe on the last program when we made the fresh fruit tart. So, very easy to make. 250 grams, I reckon. Then we're gonna need to whip some whipping cream. Let's disinfect it. Okay, whipping cream, we need 450. It's in the fridge. Where is my whisk? Right. Sorry. The whisk. Okay, time that's mixing through. We're gonna need some gelatin. Gelatin, so we're gonna make for 250, we need 3.5 gelatin leaves in a cold water to make it soft, right? Then the crème pâte has got to be mixed and smoothed, as is like a kind of a flan mixture, flan texture. So vanilla mousse, because in the crème pâtissière there is vanilla already. In French it will be called a crème diplomate. I think, yeah, crème diplomate is called. and not a vanilla mousse. But vanilla mousse is more groovy, sexy. There you go. Whipping cream nearly done. Yeah, that's done. Let's check our gelatin. The gelatin's got to go into the microwave. It's a bit hard still, you see, it's quite hard. Let it melt a little, not melt, soften a bit more. Let's check the chocolate genoise. It might be cooked now. If we see on the top, yeah, when we press, it comes up again. So it's cooked. We take it out on a rack, because if you leave it on top of your hot tray, it will dry out. So if you put it on a rack, straight it stops the heating going to it, so it's fine. Let it cool down. Gelatin now. Yeah, it's ready now. It's quite fast. Oh, let's drain it quite well. Up in a plastic bowl. Into the microwave for 10 to 15 seconds. Okay. The melted gelatin is gonna go to the smooth cream pat. And then we add the whipping cream to it to make it light. Okay. Yeah, that's good. It's melted. So just to make sure we're not gonna make some lump of gelatin into this big cream pad, because it's quite a big quantity of cold. We're just gonna take a little bit and mix it through into the warm one, warm gelatin. At this stage, you know, it's easier to incorporate the gelatin into your big cream pat to don't make lump of gelatin. Okay, this in there. Let's mix it quickly before it sets. Okay, it's mixed down now. And now we need to add the whipping cream. A little bit to start. A little bit more. Okay, and a bit more. And what's left over? Et voilà. Job done. How can we say it's a poche chantilly? That's fine. Lovely. Vanilla, slightly vanilla flavor. So now we're gonna just build our cake with the genoise. Hopefully it will be cold in a minute. Let's it cool it down before to slice it. Okay. Done. Okay, now our chocolate genoise is cooled down. And we're gonna take it out from the mold. Remove the paper. See, it's so light. a little twist. Voilà. Beautiful. So now we're going to have to slice it in three sections. Can you hear the lightness? You can hear the hair. It's fantastic. It's a real sponge. Right, so voilà. We've got our three pieces back together, right? So we need our dark chocolate mousse, which we made earlier. We're gonna need our vanilla mousse. Let's use plain board or a plate or whatever. And I made. And then we're gonna soak the sponge with a sugar syrup, which is for 1 kilo of sugar, 1 liter of water. Boil it through, and you store it in the fridge, and you can do anything with it. So it's just gonna help the moisture and the genoise to don't go too dry. And in this syrup, we're gonna add some kirsch, because it goes very well with raspberry and cherry. This is our griotines. Griotines in kirsch, yeah. So they've been preserved in alcohol, kirsch. It's very nice. I don't like it, but it's very nice. Let's take a few, yeah, voilà. Right, this syrup, I can't stop, yeah. Okay, the syrup into a container. I'm gonna add a bit of this griotine juice. I know you can't find them easily, the griotines in kirsch. Use cherries from a tin. I'm not sure if you can find any. A bit of kirsch, right? It's just by the feeling. Usually you put 10% of alcohol in any syrup, but just by the feeling. It depends how you feel. That's nice. All right. So we soak the sponge. Well on the outside. There you go. Jubbly lovely. Then a bit of... So we're gonna start with dark chocolate mousse. Dark chocolate mousse with the griotines. Okay, I need a scraper. Look at this beautiful mousse when it's set. It's fantastic. This is a sabayon, it makes everything. The richness of the yolks, yeah, no, it's great. Okay, a little snail again. Right. Voilà. Then the little cherries in there. Put some a bit everywhere. You know, this cake, you're gonna slice it in 8 portions, so make sure there's a cherries at least in every portion. Or even 3, 4, 5, 6. Voilà. A bit more mousse, but not too much. It's just to stick the other sponge layer on top. Just to hide the cherries, yeah? So, the next one, on top of it. Lovely. Sugar syrup. Yes, and now the vanilla mousse or the crème diplomate. Ah, timer, we check later. It's burned! Okay. Crème diplomate or chantilly is up to you, but seriously, with a bit of vanilla flavor test, fantastic, it's much better. Right, voilà, and then in there a few frozen raspberries, because they're so juicy, you know, the fresh raspberry we find in the supermarket, they are dry, they are bleh. If you grow them in your garden, great, but otherwise use the frozen ones, they are so juicy, it's great, it's good, it's good. I put some extra because they are nice. Voilà. Little bit more for the top bit here. Yeah. This time, voilà. And I use a palette knife just to cover it, yeah. Voilà. The last layered sponge. Look at that. Finish with syrup again. Very important. Beautiful. And now we're gonna finish around with some dark mousse to stick some chocolate shaving. Okay, so we're gonna just finish our black forest with the chocolate shaving. You can use white, dark, whatever shaving you want. Right. So we're gonna cover all around with some mousse. Voilà. Stick the chocolate shaving onto it. It's very soft. You can, before to do that, you can always let it set in the fridge. Let it set all together before to do that. But because I'm crazy, I like the risk. Voilà, voilà. A bit more here. A bit more there. Nearly ready, nearly ready.
Wait, wait.
Cocoa powder. Ah, oh, I don't have any. to finish it off. Right. And now we're gonna put it in the fridge. Let it set. Okay. So we let it set and we're gonna try a little piece in a bit. So now that's it. The Black Forest has been set in the fridge. So let's cut it. One slice. There you go. Let's put it on the plate. Very nice. Should we try it? So see, we've got the raspberry, the little cherries. It was a big spoon. Yeah, it's light, it's lovely. That's all. Good luck to make one. That's all.